Warthog. Don't be fooled by the comical trot or the short-sighted and nervous disposition of this member of the pig family. Adaptable, fierce and quick, it will scurry away should it feel threatened. The warthog will eat almost anything it discovers in the veld. This includes roots, seeds, bulbs, fruit, tubers, mushrooms and even carrion. They are medium-sized, robust animals, sparsely haired with barrel-like bodies. They have thin legs and a tufted tail that is carried stiffly erect when the animal runs. This is said to guide others into the correct escaping route. The warthog's snout is very strong and muscular, ideal for exposing and pulling up roots and tubers. Tusks can inflict deadly injuries to inexperienced predators. The ugly wart-like lumps behind the tusks are typical features. Males have tusks which are predominantly large and are a characteristic of warthogs. Skin colour is often determined by the colour of the mud that they have recently wallowed in. The animal often kneels to eat and dig. It is for this reason that large protective calluses are formed. Warthogs have a very short and strong neck, lined uppermost with a scruffy neckline. It finds food mainly by its keen sense of smell. Snouts easily plough up the ground like a spade in search of underground delicacies. An adult warthog weighs about 100 kilograms and the female 70 kilograms. The warthog makes a reassuring grunting sound when at ease and in a group. When frightened, fighting or raising an alarm, it produces a shrill squealing sound. They live and move in groups. The families consist of mothers, young and juveniles, while older males are single or live in bachelor herds. Their natural enemy is the spotted hyena. Warthogs compete successfully with other herbivores on the African savannah, where predators abound and food is often scarce. One of their habits is to use holes of ant bears and termite nests as burrows for protecting young, isolating from inclement weather and as refuge from other predators. Females line these burrows with grass. Warthogs reverse into the burrows for quick exit, and in this way, their tusks are the first to be met by an enemy or predator. They dig the holes with their forefeet and tusks and push the soil away with their snout. Warthogs are diurnal, meaning they are not active at night. They have better survival chances than any other grazers as they can dig up deep roots, bulbs and rhizomes. They favour short grassland, drink regularly and spend much time wallowing in water and mud. The young are born in the grassy burrows, but because of limited space, only three or four are born in midsummer. After about a week of age, the youngsters come out and start grazing under the watchful eye of the cow. For the first 4 to 6 months, the piglets are suckled. Mortality is high in warthogs, but losses are compensated by regular mating and by having the first litter by 18 months. Tusks are in demand from hunters as trophies. They make excellent knife handles, letter openers, and inserted into intricate rifle butt engravings. Wild dogs. When a pack of wild dogs chooses its prey, mostly springbok, impala or blue wildebeest, an orchestrated battle plan goes into action. The pack approaches openly and nonchalantly, but when its members start running, they become oblivious to everything but their target. After many tiring kilometers, the leading dogs retire for fresher ones to carry on the relentless and terrifying chase. Speeds of 65 kilometers per hour are possible. As the prey tires and slows, the pack moves in. Smaller victims like duiker or hares are immediately torn to pieces. Larger animals have chunks ripped out of them as they run until they collapse. In contrast to the savagery, the pack's behavior after the kill becomes calm and patient. The adults, clearly hungry, stand back and let the juveniles eat their fill first. Young wild dogs, still in their litters, are incessantly pampered by all adults, who clean them, guard them, and later again feed them regurgitated meat. The pack consists of 10 to 15 individuals, communicates with calls, body postures, and greeting rituals. Leopards will always and easily give way to the pack. Wild dogs occur mainly in the northern sections of South Africa. Their natural habitats vary from grasslands to very arid areas, as well as fairly dense bushlands. Hippopotamus. Hippos are not greatly unlike members of the pig family, the differences which exist being due principally to the different habits and mode of life. For example, they have certain adaptations because they are semi-aquatic. They are similar to pigs in that they have non-ruminating stomachs, stout bodies and short legs. Don't be fooled by this comical shape, the benign look and sheepish grin. This huge amphibian mammal's jaws and curved tusk-like teeth have been known to snap a man in half. Enraged bulls and cows with calves may storm a boat, so it is best to stay well clear of them at all times. Unlike pigs, all four of their toes touch the ground, the two prominent middle ones being better developed than the side ones. All toes are capped by hooves, and the inside of their mouth is pink. The youngsters are paler than the adults. A special adaptation for their aquatic lives is the positioning of the eyes, nose and ears, which protrude from the water when all the other body parts are submerged. The nostrils are mere slits and can close underwater, while the ears are small and unobtrusive. The lower incisors are developed as large tusks and are kept sharp by the upper smaller incisors that at each close of the jaw touch up the sharp edges of the teeth. Hippos are confined to water systems, preferring sloping banks with bordering grass plains. They spend most of the day in the water, either wholly or partially submerged, and emerge at night, or if the day is cool or rainy, to graze on the riverbanks. They are gregarious animals, occurring in mixed herds of up to 20 individuals. Lone bulls are often encountered. Hippos are strictly grazers, cropping the vegetation with their wide lips and often moving several kilometers inland from their rivers. These distances sometimes encroach on bordering farmlands, where they create havoc to crops. They consume up to 40 kilograms of greenery per night. The next day, this digested grass is defecated in the waterway. This is done while vigorously wagging its tail to scatter the dung over a wide area as possible. This sinking mass of grass provides nourishment and nutrients for aquatic creatures. Their role in nature is a useful one. They continually stir up sediments which have sunk to the bottom of the pool and thus make food available for other organisms. The continual movement of these animals in the river keep open waterways and reed beds. Their broad backs sometimes provide resting place for many species of bird. Hippos spend most of the day dozing in the water, their hairless skin protected from the sun. A reddish glandular secretion is sometimes visible on the skin. This is the animal's self-produced sun protection cream. Ancient Greeks called this the river horse, and in German it is also still called the Nile or river horse. When the hippo submerges, it closes its slit-like nostril and disappears for several minutes. They walk under the water and are extremely nimble aquatic movers. When the bulls reach maturity at about 7 years of age, they are driven from the herd and can only return after violent clashes with the existing bull to determine dominance. Deep wounds are often inflicted during these vicious fights, as the long incisors remain deadly. A male can have up to 14 cows in his harem. Breeding can occur at any time of the year, and after a gestation period of 8 months, females give birth to one calf on land. Calves frequently suckle underwater. An adult male weighs up to 1.8 tons, while females weigh up to 1.4 tons. Hyena. Two species of hyena occur in South Africa. The spotted hyena, common in the northern part of the country, with the brown hyena favoring more central habitat and also common along the west coast arid regions. Spotted hyenas are yellowish-grey with dark brown spots on the whole body. Brown hyenas have a brown to almost black coat with horizontal stripes over their legs. Called nature's garbage remover, the hyena plays an important role in the environment by devouring leftover kills and animals that have died of old age or sickness. Rarely hyenas hunt to supplement their diet. Dying, old, weak and infirm animals will characteristically be attacked. Hyenas have a heavy shoulder that stands higher than the hind legs, are the size of a large dog, and have an aggressive character. They often have frenzied fights amongst each other and have enormous appetites. The hyena consumes its own prey and carrion with such gusto and relish that large chunks of meat are wolfed down with minimal chewing. Their voracious appetites seem unrelenting. Hyenas are predominantly scavengers and will eat almost anything that it comes across. This includes items forgotten by campers and hunters, like boots, half-empty tins of food, and any item that just smells different. Strong stomach juices will digest the thickest bones, horns, and hooves to the toughest sinews and hardest skins. They have very strong and very heavy jawbones, teeth, and muscles. They will also consume birds, insects, reptiles, and small animals. Anything goes for good in the hyena diet. Hunters in the early 19th century have recorded attacks on humans camping in the bush. They love rummaging around human settlements, looking for anything that provides a free mouthful. These are the ones to watch out for when sleeping in the bush. Powerful long forelegs make them exceptional runners, and they use this adaptation to tire prey on the run. Hyenas are known to drive away lions, cheetahs, and leopards from their prey. They seem fearless and are known to take chances at anything. Moving in packs or clans of up to 30 individuals, the hyena diligently marks its territory with scents from anal glands and glands between the toes. It also creates latrine areas, regularly visited, which clearly mark out its territory and in no uncertain detail advertise the fact to stay out and keep out. Hyenas have exceptional night vision and an acute sense of smell and hearing. Animals on the run can reach speeds of 50 kilometers per hour. They prefer night hunting and are mostly hidden during the day. Hyenas are well known for their maniacal laughter, which occurs at times of excitement and around kills. The males also laugh when trying to attract the attention of a female. The other well-known sound is a long drawn-out whoop, often heard at night. Having in the past been called hermaphrodites or bisexual was due to the fact that females have an unusually developed clitoris resembling the penis of a male. fact that females are larger than males adds to the above confusion. After a gestation period of 3 months, females give birth to 3 or 4 cubs. Old ant bear holes and termite mounds seem to be the favorite burrow. Blue wildebeest. Driven by their need for water and their liking of fresh sprouting grass, the blue wildebeest has an amazing ability to track down a rainstorm, even if it is many kilometers away. Sometimes, in their herds of thousands, they will follow the sound of thunder, or perhaps the sight of rain clouds, until they reach the freshly fallen rain. The blue wildebeest seem to be the clumsy clowns of the wild, with their humped shoulders, sloping backs, and rocking horse gait. They make a short grunt alarm, toss their massive heads, and nervously search the air for scent of predators. Being the favorite prey for lion, they have to be on the ever alert. These grayish-brown, car-like animals, sometimes appearing slate blue in certain light, have darker vertical stripes on their necks and flanks. They have a black mane with a horse-like black tail. The black wildebeest, in turn, has a white tail with a white cropped mane. Both the blue and black wildebeest are sometimes referred to as gnu. This originates from an old Khoi word, which in principle copies the sound made when the animal huffs. The horns do not meet in the center of the skull, as in the case with buffalo, and both sexes have horns. Exceptionally inquisitive, the blue wildebeest will often stand and stare at an intruder before suddenly whirling around and galloping off. On their massive migrations, younger bulls patrol the perimeter of the herd, often relying on accompanying zebras for early warning sounds should there be any predators around. Blue wildebeest are tough, and although normally timid, will fight ferociously when cornered. They tend to be territorial, eat grasses, and prefer short, fresh grass. As these animals drink twice a day, you can always be on the lookout for them not much more than 20 kilometers away from a water source. Some of the blue wildebeest herds move in immature bachelor groups. These groups tend to be unstable, leaderless, and listless. At this stage, they do not have strong social structures. Does this perhaps sound familiar? When a predator tries to capture a blue wildebeest, the animal tends to run into the main herd, thus creating confusion and the chance that the predator singles out another target. It is a fact that chances of survival are greater in a large herd. During the breeding season, females will mate with several males in a short succession over a few days. When the female gives birth, she moves into the thicker bush away from the herd. This is to hide the infant from predators who will attack a small wildebeest if alerted. The calf takes about 5 to 10 minutes to be able to stand on its own legs. The mother, as well as her calf, rejoins the herd after about a day of rest. After this time, the calf and its mother have to keep up with the pace of the herd. Cows suckle calves for about 8 months, although it can eat tender grass after about 2 weeks after birth. The calves bleat anxiously when they are separated from their mothers. This unfortunately also attracts the attention of nearby predators. Vervet monkey. We find these monkeys over South Africa, except in the extreme south. The vervet monkey, or blow-arp, meaning blue monkey due to its blue scrotum, is an excitable and nervy creature. Vervet monkeys prefer river bush, forests and plantations. Their grey coats and black faces, with a band of white hair across the forehead and sides, are typical vervet characteristics. Their hands and feet and lower half of the tail are darker than the rest of the body. Being a primate, it can successfully adapt to a variety of habitats, including open savanna and farmland. These creatures easily become cheeky thieves in homes, bush camps and gardens. Quick to learn the way of easy survival, they will adapt to their surroundings with ease. Their natural enemies include birds of prey, cheetahs, pythons and man. They are gregarious and live in troops of up to 20 individuals with a strict code of hierarchy, defining clear ranks of minor and senior members. They are good swimmers and will freely enter water should the rewards warrant getting wet. They live to about 12 years of age and adults can weigh up to 24 kilograms. Eating and nourishment is easy for the vervet monkey as it can adapt to anything. Nutrition comes from grasses and grass seeds, berries, roots, insects, eggs, scorpions, young plant shoots, burbs, bulbs, or anything that it can get hold of. They can become very troublesome beggars. If trained to do so by the presence of man and his ever-present incorrect notion of feeding wildlife, vervet monkeys have been tamed as pets, which today has become illegal. Vervet monkeys sleep together in groups of 2 or 3, huddled together in rock crevices or on high branches. Authority is strictly maintained in the group, and senior males quickly make clear their status in the group. Subordinates don't cheek their seniors, but will vent their anger on monkeys lower down on the social scale. Males perform sentry duty and defend the group while females tend to the young. Extremely maternal, females will adopt young from other groups, and young mothers with stillborn infants will hold on to their offspring for several days. Energetic and agile, vervet monkeys will be equally at home in trees or on the ground. They are constantly foraging for food. This grey monkey will be watching you from the treetop before you even notice it. It will announce your presence to the group by chattering, screaming, and a raucous coughing. Large troops of females, especially those acclimatized to human presence, can become very threatening if food is not given. Vervet monkeys breed in the summer. Being fertile at 3 years, she will have a baby every year for about 10 years. After a gestation period of 7 months, females have a baby and very rarely twins are born. Females have breasts and cling to their babies as humans would. More adept youngsters hitch a ride on moms or any other willing individual's back. Vervet monkeys are easily the most widely distributed of all the monkeys. Chacma baboon. The Chacma baboon is a fairly large primate, grey to black in colour with a dog-like muzzle, longish tail and coarse hair, which is thicker on the neck and shoulders. Their face is naked and their buttocks have callosities. Females in estrus will display swollen bright red to pink buttocks. Females are smaller than males. Chacma baboons prefer wooded country but will also venture into open savanna and rocky outcrops. Baboons occur in troops numbering up to 100 individuals, occasionally more but usually less. These troops have well-chosen sleeping sites in tall trees, cliff faces or high caves, from which they will descend in the mornings to start the day's wanderings in search of food. Generally, baboons don't wander more than 2 kilometers from their sleeping place, unless food is scarce and a greater search area must be covered. They do not always return to the same sleeping site, of which they have several, but will return there again after a few days. Being mainly ground dwellers, baboons are vulnerable to predation. They therefore have good eyesight and exceptional hearing. When danger threatens, the vulnerable members cluster in the center of the group, while the most dominant and protective males will move along the outside. If something strange is spotted, these males usually give the alarm bark. Baboons will also associate with other animals like antelope, whose alertness supplements their own. In addition to the bark, baboons can grunt, shriek, chatter, and roar. They are omnivorous, although largely vegetarian, and will eat foods such as shoots, bulbs, seeds, grasses, scorpions, centipedes, lizards, birds, and eggs. They will also eat meat when the opportunity arises. This is especially apparent when babies of other animals are born. Baboons have also been seen feeding on carrion. They are very destructive crop raiders. Mother Chacma baboons give birth to single young after a gestation period of 6 months. Thereafter, females will not breed for 18 months. Breeding can happen at any time of the year, and the young are known to ride jockey fashion on their mothers' backs. Zebra. Sometimes jokingly referred to as pajama donkeys, this unusual animal covering has had many scientists discussing as to why nature had indeed decided on this particular coat. It has, amongst others, been debated that when heavy fly infestations occur, the constant twitching of the fur causes blood-sucking flies like the tsetse fly to become mesmerized and confused. The blurred movement of animals on the run, especially during night hunts, also confuses predators. 2 species of zebra occur in South Africa, the common and abundant Burchell zebra and the very rare Cape Mountain zebra. The Burchell zebra will be discussed here. Each zebra has its individual stripes, like fingerprints, as no 2 individuals have the same pattern. Galloping herds of zebra crossing the plain with their shining coats and rounded bodies rocking in the sun are one of the truly magnificent spectacles of the African continent. Timid yet restless, they invariably bolt from the waterhole after drinking. They are noisy and very excitable. Their piercing, whiny quaha is the same sound made as the now extinct quagga. A loud neigh, squeal or high-pitched bark are also common. You will also notice that between each stripe is a shadow of a stripe, which is particularly apparent on the hindquarters. This is said to confuse predators when large herds scurry around during an attack. Other typical features are the black tufted tail, the strong upright mane, and the black patch around the nostrils. When under attack from predators, the males will put down their own safety and courageously take a protective rearguard position, while the rest of the group flees. In very large herds, stallions will also form a defensive line along the flanks. The Burchell zebra's habit of keeping close to herds of grazing wildebeest is not coincidental, as this is a strategy to increase herd survival. Most predators prefer eating wildebeest. Zebras also easily mix with other sociable antelope and also ostrich. The zebra stallions are fiercely protective of their young, and the male will use bare teeth to scare predators. Flinging hooves become deadly to attacking lions and hyenas. Zebra are grazers preferring typical grassland and savannas. They are gregarious, consisting of family groups all living together. Water and good grazing are important habitat requirements, and if either is lacking, they will migrate to better areas, moving as much as 40 kilometers per night. They are also known to uproot plants, to feed off roots and tubers. The lifespan, like so many other animals, is determined by the condition of the teeth. As these become increasingly worn, ineffective grazing takes place and the animal loses condition at about 20 years of age. This weakened individual then becomes the specific target of lions, which are the main predators of zebra. Single young are born in winter from July to August, after a gestation period of 12 months. The mating is an extremely quick affair, taking place about every hour for 2 days on end. Young mothers are extremely aggressive and even attack members of her own herd who venture too close to her foal. Foals are ready to graze young shoots after 3 days and are eventually totally weaned at 10 months. Foals are often seen consuming their mother's dung. This ensures that the necessary stomach bacteria are introduced to each offspring. Man has in the past tried to domesticate zebra, and many an ox wagon was drawn by zebra. Being the main prey of lions, this later proved to be a dangerous occupation for wagon drivers. In captivity, zebra have on rare occasions crossed with donkeys, producing young referred to as zonkies.
Ha ha! Mama!